My name is Luisa Escobar Hoyos. I am an assistant professor in the Department of Therapeutic Radiology at Yale University. I had a really strong model behind wanting to pursue research in cancer and becoming a scientist. So my mom is also a cancer scientist, and truly what motivated me to follow her steps was seeing all the impact that she was having on students, on trainees, on the future generation of scientists. And I think indirectly she had that effect on me. So that really motivated me to become a cancer scientist, a woman in science, and being a leader and role model for other future generations. I was recently awarded a Career Development Award from the AACR to further diversity and inclusion in pancreatic cancer research. I see this award as a mechanism to further inclusion from a demographic perspective, but also from a scientific perspective where we're trying to tackle and understand understudied pathways that potentially are used by this tumor, and that's what makes it so different. My field of cancer research is mainly right now pancreatic cancer research. And we're trying to understand how these tumor cells hijack into a pathway of cells called RNA splicing. And this is by looking at a particular pathway called alternative RNA splicing. And we always think, you know, one gene encodes for one protein, but it's potential that one gene can encode up to 7 different proteins, and we really don't understand what this diverse proteome is doing. And our previous research and our findings show that actually pancreatic cancer uses a lot of these pathway, the alternative splicing, to generate different proteins that have sometimes different effects. And these tumor cells actually cope into this pathway to first transform from normal cells to cancer cells. And then afterwards, also they use this pathway to respond and to become so resistant to the therapies that we give them, for example, to chemotherapy or targeted therapies, and making them very quick to rewire and overcome the perturbation of a therapy. So we think now that we have identified a core pathway that we can actually start understanding, but also drugging it or targeting it in many different ways to make it specific for the tumor cells and to make it and to tackle this dependency of these cells. I am particularly excited about RNA therapies and RNA-based vaccines, and that's exactly what I work on. What I see exciting about RNA-based therapies is, as we have learned with the COVID vaccines, how potent they are. And so what we're trying to do with our RNA-based therapies is to force and correct the splicing defects that the cancer cells really depend on, and just reversing them into what would be the normal pattern of RNA splicing. What we like about this approach is that first, it's based on a technology that is now well established and it has a big momentum. Second, that it's a therapy where we can actually design these RNA splicing correcting therapies in a large scale and very quickly. So it's a very rapid, plastic, and scalable RNA-based therapies. And so far, our animal studies are showing us that these therapies work, that they decrease the size of the tumor, that they enhance the survival of these pancreatic cancer models. And so we're hopeful that that is where, at least for pancreatic cancer, we can bring our input and start testing. We are also bringing new small molecule inhibitors that tackle this pathway, which is also very exciting, and we're hoping to start a clinical trial soon on this. Career development awards are very important. When we start as junior PIs, we are really trying to break through with new ideas. And sometimes we don't have all the preliminary data that is necessary to go and apply for, you know, government funding. These new awards that support new ideas, even if a lot of data is not in place, tries to get us the first funding so we can start actually producing all that data that later we can ramp it up and advance our careers. So I really see it as an important stepping stone into making a change in the way that we approach science, and also getting that original funding that is a seed before we can actually start growing and producing that later goes into larger grants.